dangerous waters.
Are there sharks, Captain Creed?
Worse.
Flesh-eating piranhas?
Worse.
Man-eating whales?
Worse than all those put together.
Jeepers, guys, there's no such thing as a man-eating whale.
Oh, yeah? What about Moby Dick?
Yeah, you ought to know about him, Ishmael.
Can I help it if my folks love that book?
Ishmael's right. There's no such thing as a man-eating whale.
What could be worse than all those horrible things, Sam?
I'll tell you, landlubber. Word is that the owner's going to be aboard the flounder on this trip.
Oh, that sounds bad.
Sure, they're probably real nice. And gosh, if I owned a boat like this, I'd be real happy about it. I guess, I mean, it floats.
Happy? Not when you got this tub next to the Carnival cruise ships. It's a tugboat next to the Queen Mary. Word has it, if this trip is a success, owner's thinking of taking her to sea, deep six in her.
She'd make a nice coral reef.
Ishmael! The flounder has been Uncle Charlie's home for 30 years. You wouldn't want to see your place turned into a coral reef, would you?
Wouldn't mind a bit.
My girlfriend's name is Coral. Coral reef.
That's ridiculous.
You don't have a girlfriend.
Want to see your photo?
You probably cut that picture out of the magazine.
Saving the flounder. This ship's got a lot to offer.
Like what?
Built in 1951, when ships were ships, not shopping malls. Look at the fine designs, and she's built to last.
Captain, I forgot to tell you, there's a leak in my cabin.
Get some chewing gum and plug it up.
Listen, everyone, we should be happy that Uncle Charlie took us on as his crew.
Thank you, Uncle Charlie. Even if I do get seasick easily.
So grateful. Nobody with experience is signing up for this ship. They all want to be on the new fancy cruise liners.
But what have they got that the flounder doesn't have?
Three swimming pools, clubs, midnight cafes,
Broadway shows.
But we got heart. We got class. We got crew to passenger ratio that make those other ships envious.
Yeah, because this cruise is only a third full.
It doesn't matter, guys. We're going to show these people the best time they'll ever have at sea.
But they won't even know each other.
Yeah, it's a singles cruise. Then we'll just have to introduce them to one another. We'll just have to make sure that romance is in the air.
Yeah, what's that smell?
It's a little greasy for romance.
Dang, she'd be leaking oil again. Ishmael, run down and see what's on the oil pan.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Just remember, crew, we need to show everyone the best time at sea, especially the owners.
Who's the owner, anyway?
That's just it. I don't know. For business purposes, it's a silent partnership. Very silent.
How do you know the owner's going to be on board, then?
Company lawyer sent me an email. Order to be aboard on this trip. Make sure success, or you go down with it.
Gosh, that about says it all.
Chris! You're the cruise director, so make sure there's never a dull moment.
Aye, aye. I'll go wipe the ship with those folks.
And Naomi and Nick, you make sure the dining room service is perfect.
I'll go wash the forks again right now.
And I'll spit shine every spoon.
Darcy, you make sure the cabins are in order.
I'll double the chocolates on everybody's bed.
Oh, Sam, I don't know if we can pull this off.
What do you mean? You've been sailing the ship for 30 years and never had a bad trip yet.
Well, what's wrong?
Not a thing, Sam. Not a thing.
Come on, I know something's bothering you.
Just a bit superstitious is all.
About what?
The date coming up, June 10th.
June 10th? What's so bad about that? I can see you getting worried about Friday the 13th or the Ides of March, but June 10th? That's just another day.
No, Lassie, tis not. Tis worse than all those combined. Made sure I was ashore in the past, but this year the schedule. She tricked me.
Captain Creed to the engine room. Captain Creed to the engine room. And, could you bring some duct tape?
Sam, you're the first, sir. Go see the passengers. They can come in aboard quick as a whistle. I'll get the duct tape.
You can set the bags down here, Jarvis.
Very good, Your Highness.
Shh! I'm not Your Highness on this voyage, Jarvis. You know this.
I'm sorry, Your Highness.
Jarvis!
Old habits die hard, you're...
much better.
His Royal Highness Prince Alexander de Gou, Jarvis speaking. It's your father.
Daddy dear, how is everything in Cotslovia? Good, glad to hear it. Yes, we're on the ship. But I don't see why we can't build on something a bit newer, though. I know, we've got to focus. We've got to concentrate. No, I haven't met anyone. We just got on board. Give me a chance. Yes, I won't disappoint you. I'll find somebody to be the princess. No, it won't just be anybody. All right. I knew being a prince would be so hard, I would sign up for this topic.
Your father took a bride at 20, his father before him took a bride at 19. Your great-grandfather was wed at 18. And you're 22 and long overdue, I'm sorry, but what am I supposed to call you?
I'll think of something.
It appears on the starboard side, this way.
Any sign of Big Eddie?
What? I think he is going to be on the ship.
Are you sure? We made sure we'd cover the tracks.
Yeah, but you know Big Eddie. He can find a needle in a haystack.
How do you know? We're laying real low. He shouldn't find us.
Yeah, but I don't know. I didn't tell anyone Max would be on this. Swear.
Are you positive, Bubba?
Positive.
You don't sound positive, Bubba.
Didn't mention it to anyone.
Pretty slick of us sneaking with all the food.
Yeah, except next time, you be the one who acts like a side of beef. It got real cold in that meat locker.
What are you talking about? I had to swim in olive oil.
Oh, so that's why you smell like a salad.
I hear someone coming. Let's find a place to lay low.
I think they came in here.
Big Edie Shelf.
Sorry, Edie. I just got so used to that stupid Max talking about Big Eddie all the time.
Yeah, that bum's a real crumb. First he borrows money from my people, then he doesn't pay it back. He doesn't know who he's dealing with.
That for sure. He thinks you're a man. Ha ha.
All be easier to catch him, Violet.
Blah, I hate that name.
On this trip, Toots, you're Violet. And who am I?
Prudence
was?
Prudence the mom from her gypsy.
And don't you forget it. Now, let's not lose our scent. One of them smells like raw meat, and the other smells like a salami sandwich. Oh, Pitts, isn't this the absolute end?
The end of what?
Of everything. This is the most romantic ship I've ever been on.
You said this is the first ship you've ever been on.
It's so romantic. I know it'll inspire me to write my greatest novel yet. I can see it now. My beloved Estella La Bella finding the man of her dreams on the SS Flounder.
You want me to start taking notes now, Miss Devine?
Not yet. I need to soak up the atmosphere. Every last drop.
I have a towel if you get too wet.
This must be the lounge. Kind of old-fashioned.
Real wooden. Real masculine.
If it's so masculine, then where are the guys?
I don't know. Maybe they're back here.
Or hiding in here.
Oh, gosh. Books?
I want to see a book, read a book, or think about a book for the next 8 days.
You're absolutely right. We're on vacation from books.
Now, where is that butternut? There it is. Let's take a Leno? I've got a knife?
No books. Forget it. The sight of blood makes me sick.
Let's just make a vow.
No books.
And that's pretty hard for three librarians to say.
Three librarians. Finally on vacation.
I wonder what they're doing back at the library.
Shelving.
Shelving. And more shelving.
But what about the guys?
If there aren't guys, I'm throwing myself overboard.
You're right.
I believe so. Marty! Marty!
They're just a shy.
Come in, you boys. It's all right.
Here we are.
This is Marty and
this is Marty.
Say hello, boys.
Hello, boys.
I'm Laura.
I'm Nora.
I'm Dora.
The boys have really been looking forward to the singles cruise, haven't you, boys?
What are you guys looking forward to on this trip?
Dancing?
Long walks in the moonlight?
How about you?
I think I'm going to read a lot.
Me too. Oh, dear. Good afternoon, boys. I'm sure you can think of something to talk about. Not that way. Where are you going? Need some help? I'm further beyond that. I wanted to be close to my boys, but this is ridiculous. No, they're like stereotypical young girls. I thought maybe now on the singles cruise, I could nudge them in the right direction. But I'm afraid they're hopeless.
Mrs. Marks, this is a cruise into romance and adventure.
We can help your boys.
All they need is a little time in our spa.
There's a spa board?
Oh, and we specialize in makeovers. Marty and Murray will be in good hands.
You lost us.
Because you ran the other way. But don't worry. These two ladies are going to take them to the spa and turn you into tigers.
Don't worry, Mr. Marks. One won't catch your kittens.
I wish somebody would.
Thought I'd never get across the gangway.
I couldn't look down. You might have fallen in if I did.
But looky here. This must be the lounge.
Oh my. Pretty, isn't it?
And look at that fish.
Reminds me of my first husband.
I don't see the resemblance.
Oh, sure. Those eyes and those lips. Don't you remember how old Mortimer looked so much like a fish?
Since you say that, I do remember. That was a long time ago.
Three husbands ago.
Is that one of them, Miss Crew Sister? You looking for number four?
Oh, gracious no. I'm here for some R&R.
R&R?
Rest and relaxation.
We get plenty of that, sister dear.
You can never get enough R&R.
You act as if you could fall asleep at the drop of a hat.
I don't think this is our cabin, darling.
Darling, don't you dare call me darling.
Why not?
We're not married.
I have a little ring on my finger that says otherwise.
Well, get rid of it. Give it to me.
Why?
You know why? This is a singles cruise.
So? We'll show them all what it's like to be happily married.
No way! I will get my story if anybody knows we're married.
Oh, your story. Your story. That's all I ever hear.
But this could be my big break.
What? A singles cruise on this little rowboat?
I know everybody isn't going to be famous, but I guarantee I'm going to get a fantastic story out of this.
And meanwhile, I'll be stuck in my own little cabin.
Next to mine.
Absence makes the heart go fonder, darling.
I was thinking more along the lines of out of sight, out of mind.
Jackie, darling, wait.
Excuse me, have we been introduced?
That ought to do it.
Yeah, my dad always said if duct tape can't fix it, it can't be fixed.
Oh, Captain!
Are we glad we found you?
What be wrong?
I saw the signs of beef get up and walk away.
And I saw the olive oil flew the way.
Buddy, these two are seasick already, and we aren't even moving.
It's no laughing matter. Something fishy in the kitchen.
We haven't halibut for lunch.
Don't say we didn't warn you.
Ready to cast off, Captain?
Aye, Ishmael. The sooner we'd be heading out, the sooner we'd be heading back. Anchors away.
Anchors away.
Esther, answer the phone. Esther, I answered it last time. Esther, you don't answer the phone.
Good. They stopped ringing.
Thank you.
chasing us?
No. They were older, more distinguished, sleeping on two deck chairs by the swimming pool.
I didn't even see a swimming pool.
Yeah, it was that puddle of water back on the little deck.
Oh, I thought that was a bird bath.
Why would birds need a bath on a ship if they got the whole ocean?
What about the guys? The guys?
Yeah, I must have missed them.
Something's wrong with your radar, Flora. They were sleeping right there on two deck chairs.
Nor you're seeing things.
Those were two old ladies.
Gosh, it must have been the glare of the sun or something. I'm sure they look like Brad Pitt and Zac Efron.
I've heard that when people have been at sea for too long, out in the salty water and the sun, they begin to hallucinate.
We floated up the port an hour ago.
Must be too long for some people.
Guess it's just wishful thinking.
Yeah, and I thought I saw Chris Pratt sitting at the Cafe Grande.
I'm sure I walked right past Will Smith on our way to our cabins.
Ladies, we're all daydreaming.
Apparently, that's all I've been doing on this trip.
And you can be sure I never spend my share of my wings on this single cruise if I thought I'd spend it single. I'd have bought that little chihuahua in the pet shop window.
Maybe you'll be able to find a chihuahua on this cruise.
Yeah, there are enough dogs around.
Look, we're acting like we tossed the money overboard.
Didn't we?
Look, when life gives you lemons,
make lemonade.
That's right, and there are guides on this ship, and all we need to do is cast our line in the water and we'll catch something.
My luck, I'll get a flat tire.
Why are we going to wait? The only thing we got, ourselves. Come on, I've got a great idea.
I knew it. You told somebody. Fine, I told my mother. I didn't want mommy to worry. You know telling your mother is like pinning out on the front page of the New York Times. But I told her not to say a word. Your mother was probably too busy blabbing. She didn't hear that part.
But we don't gotta worry, Max.
Don't worry. I just owe Big Eddie 100,000 clams, and you tell me not to worry.
We only left the port an hour ago. We could get one of those boat rafts and jump overboard.
Jump overboard? Jump overboard? What are you, some kind of nut?
Sure. Tonight, when it's real dark, we'll open up a little door right above the waterline, toss the raft out, jump in the water, hop in the raft, and row back to land.
You know what? You're crazy.
Oh, what are you, chicken?
Absolutely. This is one chicken who can't swim.
You can't swim? You can't swim?
I hate water. I can't even take a bath.
Oh, is that why you always smell?
Take showers, you numbskull. I just hate being surrounded by water.
Yeesh, you better not look out on deck.
No kidding. Thanks to you, we'll have to hide this entire trip.
We won't anyways, Max. We're stowaways, remember? Unless
what?
We're in disguise.
In disguise, why didn't I think of that?
Because I'm the brains, Max, and don't you forget it.
You're the brains? You're the brains, I'll give you some brains.
Max, look over there. An open cabin. Maybe we can find a disguise in there?
You're the brains, huh? If you had so many brains, we wouldn't be stuck in this pickle in the first place.
I never told you to put money down on that sway back in 10.
How was I supposed to know that horse was over the hill?
There's nothing to be afraid of, Marty.
What are you going to do with us?
We're just going to make you...
Make us what?
Real cool.
Are you going to put us in a refrigerator?
We're going to do a makeover.
A makeover?
La la.
I've never kissed a girl before.
Never? Didn't you go to prom?
We went to an all-boys school.
Oh, then I guess you didn't get out much.
Where did we go?
Darcy, this could be harder than we thought.
Come on, Sam. You always like a challenge. Remember that one time in class when you trained that chimpanzee to whistle a happy tune?
We're going to make you look like this.
you seasick?
I don't know. The last time I felt this way was when I was air sick.
Gosh, and we're not in the air.
Miss Cruise Director, would you go out with this guy?
Maybe this isn't such a good idea after all. Come on, no backing out now. In a couple hours, you don't even know yourself.
How do I look, Jarvis?
Oh, sir, your highness.
Listen, women these days don't fall for nice guys. They like someone tough, rough around the edges.
You appear rough all over, your highness.
Listen, if my father knows that we come home without a prince or a princess, he's going to be mad. You know he's going to be mad at.
If I may see frankly, your highness, it isn't my fault he spoiled you to the point where you couldn't get a second date in the bachelor if you paid the poor girl.
Jarvis, when I'm king, I'm going to fire you. But until then, you are...
Squeaky.
Squeaky McNeil. Let's browse, Squeaky.
I think our cabin is down.
Watch out. Those guys look tough.
Get out your notebook. Excuse me, sir.
Watch it, lady. I'm packing it wrong.
Oh, sir. Fishing this far out at sea isn't very good unless you've got a lot of bait. Now come and sit. If I may say so, your highness, you look like a fool.
Show us what you know. She has a hops for me. Come on.
How are you ever going to find Max, Biggie?
Prudence. I'm Prudence, remember?
Yeah, Prudence the Milo.
And you are?
Violet Prince.
And don't forget it.
So, how are you going to find Max? I mean, you don't even know what the guy looks like.
It's simple. He looks like the gangster.
Very old school.
Suit, fedora, and he walks around saying things like, I'm packing a rod.
And what are you going to do when you find him?
He's going deep sea fishing without a boat.
Marty.
Oh, ma'am, everything's spinning so bad, I don't know.
you hadn't wakened me then.
I was dreaming about eating a steak. It was 3 inches thick and filled my plate.
Esther, you know the last time you ate a steak, your teeth got stuck in the meat.
I said I was dreaming, and in my dream I still had all my teeth. And my baked potato was so big, I needed a separate bowl for it. And I put a whole tub of butter in it and a quart of sour cream.
Stop it, Esther.
Don't you want to hear about the asparagus tips?
Now you're making me hungry.
Dinner. I must have been thinking about dinner.
I wonder if they have any left.
There's only one way to find out.
Will we leave? Of course, and ask.
And if that doesn't work, we'll just raid the kitchen.
Well,
You are a professor.
I drummed the hair of his way. Just like that. How do you know that?
I was just wondering. I'm not sure. Do you want to go?
Yeah, why not?
Right?
have a bit of entertainment tonight.
Chris, are you alright?
I would be if we just stopped rocking and rolling. Rocking and rolling.
Are you doing one of those things on your wrist that I gave you in case you're getting seasick? Dr. Slipslop swears by them.
I got one on both my wrists, both my ankles, and I'd even tie one around my neck if I do any good.
Well, maybe the entertainment will make you feel better.
Sure, why not? Alright, everyone, we're going to have a bit of entertainment tonight. A passenger's quiz. For every correct answer, you'll get a coupon for a latte at the Cafe Cafe. And you can't answer a question by yourself because that wouldn't be fair. So, here we go. Our first question is, which passenger on this cruise writes romance novels?
I know. Hyphen Divine. And all her books are divine.
That's correct. Here you go. Our next question is, which passenger on this cruise is from the Kingdom of Potsdovia?
This girl right here.
Miss Jarvis.
We call her Squeaky. Squeaky.
Here you go. Oh, and what about this question? Which pair of ladies knit 1,000 scarves for our servicemen overseas?
Why, these two, right here, Hester and Esther.
And Hester and Esther. Why don't you stand up and we'll give you a nice big hand of applause for all your patriotic handwork.
Thank you so much. If you're not Hester and Esther, who are you?
Lolly and Dolly. Oops, look at the time. It's time for evening constitutional. Ready? I can't wait to constitute. Let's go.
Something fishy about those ladies.
Yeah, I don't think they knit at all.
Well, we'll straighten that out later.
Sam, I got.
Well, I guess that ends the contest, and I don't think we have anything else on the schedule for tonight.
I'm Flora.
I'm Dora.
I'm Nora.
We are the Ghost Bay Ganders here to entertain you.
2, 4, 6, 8. Who do we appreciate? Goose Bay, all the way. Goose Bay Ganders are A-O-K.
Thank you.
on.
Aye, tell First Mate Nate to keep it steady.
Aye, aye, Captain.
Ah, Chris, have you been keeping the passengers busy? Too busy to talk? I remember how it was. I was just a first class seaman when the waves started to rock, roll, rock, roll, rock, roll.
Oh, Chris, are you feeling any better?
Still getting your sea legs, I'm afraid. All the passengers in their cabins?
I think so, Uncle Charlie. All except the stowaways.
Ollie and Dolly? Come with Dizzy on Dave, so I've heard to tell.
Maybe. Maybe not.
What are you suggesting?
I think we have some pretty suspicious characters on this cruise.
Suspicious in what way?
I just don't get the feeling that any of them are who they say they are.
Sure they are. We took a look at their picture IDs, didn't we?
But how can we trust their picture IDs?
Blimey, here it be June 10th.
Oh, Uncle Charlie, you can't chalk up the storm and all these wacko passengers to superstition.
It's not superstition. They curse.
Any luck?
Can't find anything, Sam. Not so much as a fire hose out of place.
Fire? Did you say fire?
She said fire hose, Uncle Charlie. Relax.
That'd be hard to do. Tis June 10th. What are you be looking out there for anyway?
Oh, just before the storm hit, we were sure we'd
hear a dog barking!
Huh? I thought it sounded like a
Saint Bernard. But it turned out to be a
Pekingese.
You know, they bark like this. Yip, yip, yip.
What, you didn't find the pub?
Not so much as a swagger tail.
If you find anything close to looking like a dog, report it to me at once. Carry on.
Oh, Sam, I guess he doesn't know about the...
The good news, if there's any good news, is we should be in port by 6.
Gosh, he ought to know someone might have a gun. Yeah, they could, like, shoot a hole in the boat and it would sink. And I don't look good in a life vest.
No, we can't tell Uncle Charlie about that now. He's so worried about it being June 10th, there's no telling what he'd do if we have any more bad luck.
What's so special about June 10th?
I don't know, but it makes Friday the 13th feel like Christmas.
Why, ladies, you shouldn't be out of your cabin. This storm's a Lulu.
What storm?
We just took a bit of a stroll on deck and wanted to relax in our favorite chairs.
But you'd be so much more comfortable in bed.
But dear, it's only 10:30.
And we never go to bed this early.
We like to watch The Late Show.
And then The Late Late Show.
And what comes after that, Esther?
I know, The Late 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 Show.
Oh no, then it's Good Morning America. Still think that was such a close call with Uncle Charlie there?
Yeah, I'm just gonna find out. And that
would have been a disaster. Who knows what he would have done?
Yes.
Say, look what I found on the cereal by the boat deck, right next to an overturned trash can somebody ran into.
Gosh, Ishmael, those really aren't you.
Very funny.
Why, Esther, those clothes look familiar.
They should. They're ours. That's my favorite dress from JCPenney.
And my Sunday go-to meeting dress.
Why would you leave them in the stairwell?
Young man, we always hang our clothes up.
Somebody stole these.
You've got to be kidding.
It was Lolly and Dolly.
That's right. They were sitting right there.
And look, Esther, there's a hole in my dress.
I'd say a .38 caliber holder.
That wasn't a gunshot earlier. That was just a trash can hitting the metal railing.
Oh, you're right. Now that you mention it, it does just look like a boring old rip.
Don't worry, lady. No, she just helps you write those lurid love stories.
I just type. That's all I do. I never think about what I'm typing.
You know, this is really very silly. This is a single screw. And you better stay single. As an expert in love, I can tell you that it's impossible to tell as anyone has gotten together, as they say in the vernacular. Well, being an expert in love, haven't you ever heard of love at first sight? Surely you don't believe in that kind of nonsense.
Oh, it's not nonsense, Miss Devine.
What would you know about it?
I was in love once a long time ago.
Really? Well, I guess it can happen to anyone then.
I was a senior in high school. I loved him with all my heart. We would walk home from school, hand in hand, and carry my books because he was so strong. We'd go on picnics on the warm summer weekends and watch the clouds drift across the sky. We spent hours planning our future. We knew we wanted a house with a white picket fence, marigolds instead of a lawn, and six little ones running around the yard. It was going to be so wonderful. But then, I had to move away. And somehow, we lost touch. But there isn't a day that goes by that I don't think of him. And I've never lost hope that one day, one wonderful day...
Wow, that really is true love. Look at us, a couple of lovesick schoolgirls. I guess we are acting rather silly.
You aren't going to tear each other's hair out?
Not when there's no beauty parlor on board. This is going to take chapter 6. Love in a lifeboat. You better stay away from Simon or you'll end up in a lifeboat. Finders, keepers, losers, weepers. You.
I guess we're not the only ones out on such a nasty night.
There are other fools in the world.
Hey, who are you calling a fool?
Why, aren't you Duke the Man?
And you're the Queen of Love?
Have you read me?
Not yet. Jarvis, go get my glasses. Jarvis, go and look for thugs.
Thugs, your?
And square, Squeaky, get lost.
Thugs, huh? You wouldn't happen to be looking for Big Edie, would you?
You know Big Edie?
I've heard the name tossed around.
Who's tossing it?
Well, who wants to know? His name is Duke Demand. What business are you in, Duke Demand?
Baby food.
What kind?
The kind is all smushed and stuffed in, John.
Why? You meant the guy who codes for the label, were you?
That's me.
I wonder why I could never trust that kid. Can I trust you now?
Why not?
Where did you hear about Big Edie?
My people tell me she's on the flounder.
Who's Big Edie? She's the queen of the north side, south side, the east side, and the west side. That's ridiculous. There are no queens in New York. She's the queen of crime.
Oh, that kind of queen.
And she's on this tub?
So my people tell me.
What a new layer of excitement.
Speaking of layers of excitement, they're serving devil's food cake at the Cafe Cafe.
Devil's food? I haven't had that stuff in ages.
Maybe it's time you gave it another whirl.
Maybe it is.
Jackie, here you are.
Why, Mr. Doyle, you haven't been looking for me, have you?
Only everywhere.
Sounds like a stalker to me.
Jackie, you know that's ridiculous.
Look, I don't even know you, so what's all this fuss about?
Oh, you're really saying that.
Excuse me, but I've got to go see a man about Big Edie.
What is she talking about?
Oh, Simon, don't worry about her.
But we're...
Hush, I know you want to say that we're head over heels in love with each other. We're just this side of married.
That side, actually.
Okay. Well, she's in love with her job, whatever it is. She's just not that into you.
Whoa, wait. Did she tell you that?
Okay. Any woman can see it in her eyes, but don't worry. There are plenty of other fish in the sea.
I don't want another fish. I want Jackie.
Oh, come. You're too much a man for her.
I say.
You're not from around here, are you?
What makes you say that?
That was no domestic dip. It was imported.
Shall we?
Shall we? What do?
Devil's food cake.
You little devil, you. Good, she's not here.
But you might stick around and find us.
Let her. We can get them. Marty! Marty! She'll look back there.
Act like a block of ice.
All right, girls, hit it.
Sock it to him, sock it to him, sit, boom, sock. Sock it to him, sock it to him.
What makes you say that?
I was a cheerleader. Potawatomi University, 1977. I cheered my heart out for good old PU.
Gosh, old cheerleaders never die. We're all turning into old cheerleaders.
But cheerleading is like riding a bike. Once you learn, you don't forget. I remember all the moves.
Show us.
Look at the butts on the court. Look how they're fat and short. Look how they look like ants. Come on, team, kick them in the pants.
Ooh. Are you all right?
A plum walk could never run a trip without you. Come on, girl. I'm sure that's really done.
What about the guys?
What guys?
See you later, Tiger.
After a while, we'll knock it out.
That mean
you've never met my Aunt Bertha.
Whoa, wait,
scare the teeth right out of a wolf's head.
Well, it sounds like Big Eddie's just gonna try and do that.
But they can't flush us out.
Why not?
Because he never got flushed in.
But you know what?
What?
They think we still look like old ladies. They don't know where we are. So all we have to do is lay low.
Engine room low?
Engine room low.
Simon, where are you?
Oh, there you are.
Got your story yet?
Well, I think it's coming together. I think Duke the Man is really a guy named Big Eddie, and he's chased a pair of hoods onto the ship, and now they're stowaways.
How exciting.
And I think that those two who got makeovers are really princes.
I thought there was only one.
That was probably just to throw me off track.
Do you have anything about the reporter who's way too jealous for her good?
I don't have anything about that. Oh, wait, you mean...
You have nothing to be jealous about.
I know, I guess I was acting kind of silly.
Oh, young man.
Me?
Yes, you look so big and strong.
Oh, no. He's really very malnourished and weak. Nonsense. Would you be able to give us a hand?
We've got a job in our cabin that only a real man can do.
Go ahead, you're a real man. You know, I'd stay away from that kind of lady.
Good advice, Hester. She's the jealous type.
Now, right this way, our TV conked out right before the end of the movie.
And we just gotta find out what happens at the end.
What were you watching?
Titanic.
Maybe they're in the cheerleader's cabin?
Over my
Simon, can we talk?
I don't have anything to say.
Okay, at least hear out.
And why should he listen to you?
I'm on your side.
Oh yeah, the way you were looking at him last night at dinner is being on my side.
I didn't know he was taken. Is he?
Am I?
I've got to find some place to hide.
Really, you're...
Tut, tut, Squeaky.
If you persist in this charade...
I need to find someone who will appreciate me.
He knew he had so much to offer, but somehow, all the women he had ever met were always blinded by the glitz, the glamour. They never saw his keen heart or his kind mind.
Really hit the nail on the head there.
Do you want to hear more?
I'm afraid Duke goes other two are pursued.
Let's head to the library. I don't think they can read anyway. Read on, lady. Read on.
His father was anxious for him to marry in order to carry on the family name, but it seemed impossible until he walked into the tent in the middle of the desert, and there she stood.
I don't like this.
Me neither.
We don't know where the boys are.
Honest.
There's not an honest bone in your bodies.
Hey, my teeth are all mildly.
All right, we're not cheerleaders.
I knew it. You're nothing but a bunch of gold diggers.
We are not.
We're librarians.
You just want to get your clutches into my two boys.
Not exactly.
Then what exactly?
We just want to get our clutches into anybody.
My boys aren't just anybody. They aren't, and you should be glad.
They're very kind and funny. By the way, we thought they'd be fun to hang around with on this trip.
And then what? Drop them like hot potatoes, leave me to pick up the pieces?
Gosh, lady, we're not into breaking hearts.
Besides, there's only two of them, and there's three of us.
Well, it doesn't make any difference. You three scared my two boys right off this ship.
We didn't scare anybody.
You did.
All crew and passengers, iceberg dead ahead, iceberg dead ahead.
That's crazy! This is the Caribbean! But big chunks of ice have been breaking out by Antarctica.
And floating north!
They're the size of Rhode Island!
It's global warming! I don't care if they find us.
But she's got a gun!
Oh, my babies.
Who has a gun?
Some crazy lady. Crazier than these.
She thinks we owe her money.
Hey. Well, where have you been all night?
In a lifeboat.
Well, looks like we'll be needing those lifeboats after all. Come here, boys. You're staying with Mom.
If we're going to go down with the ship, then he wants to go down with you girls.
Aw, isn't that sweet?
Just like Titanic. Mrs. Marks! Mrs. Marks!
I'll get the smelling salt.
No, let her sleep.
All right, everybody, hold it right there.
Mrs. DeMilo, please, there's no need for a gun. We have plenty of room in all of the lifeboats.
Shut up.
You tell him, Big Edie.
Big Edie?
That's my name. Don't wear it out.
You're the queen of the north side, the south side, and the east side.
Don't forget the west side, sister. And you two owe me some bucks.
I'm afraid you're mistaken.
We pay all our bills on the 15th of every month.
Fork it over or I'll turn you into Swiss cheese.
That would be hard to do with the water gun.
A water gun?
Yes, it's leaking all over.
I want my 10 grand. Give it to me.
You sure you want it?
Yeah, give it to her.
Okay.
Oh no.
Somebody just came up behind me and whacked me on the head.
An iceberg? That is the most ridiculous thing I have ever heard.
Oh, Captain! It's an iceberg. Come on, we'll show you. Marty! Murray!
Where is everybody?
We gotta hide.
That gal got rocks in her purse.
Is that?
Man, first work on that really keeps me in check.
Let's hide it here. Well, look who we got here.
Hello, Big Eddie.
See, Max, I told you, it's Big
Edie. This ain't no dame. This is just a wig.
Oh, now where do you think you're going?
You need to fix that hole in my dress.
I want my 10 grand, Max.
Get back here, you two no good bums.
Well, that certainly worked up an appetite.
I know. I need a bit of rest before we go down to the dining room, though.
A girl after my own heart.
But what if we hit that iceberg out there?
I guess breakfast will be a little late.
Attention, all passengers and crew, attention. While you be seen off the port side of the Thunder isn't an iceberg. I repeat, it's no iceberg. Tis the Carnival Cruise Ship Fun Time. Wave as they go by.
You want a story, we'll give you a story.
I don't think I want it that bad.
But with you for protection, Big Edie won't hurt us.
It's Eddie! Big Eddie!
Let me go! Let me go!
No, our story has to be told! A story of intolerance, injustice,
and your own stupidity!
Baba!
What?
Shut up!
Simon, thank goodness you came in when you did!
I wouldn't let anything happen to you.
I know, I've been so foolish. Let's get out of here.
Together?
I don't care about my story right now. I just care about us.
Scout Donner?
Scout Donner.
Hester, I told you they're married.
For once, I think you're right, Hester.
What happened?
You told me to shut up, and I saw little stars and birds flying around.
Speaking of flying, we should get out of here.
But where?
Here. Take this.
But I can't swim.
But with these, you don't need to swim, Bubba. You see right out there? That's land. That's freedom.
But what about sharks?
The only sharks around here are on this boat.
So, we got you at last.
But not for long. Last one in the drinks are on end.
Wait, wait. Did they just... Why, those two bums?
They gave us the slip.
But we'll get them.
Just wait till we get our hands on them.
Hey, what's this?
We got tickets.
Yeah, we paid good money for this cruise.
But whose money is the question?
You can't pin anything on us.
I think there are some authorities on the island who'd like to have a little talk with you two. What island? We're docking at Ishtapapu.
Ishtapapu? Big Edie, isn't that where you...
I want a lawyer. I want to see my lawyer.
It says there's a lot of clubs on Ishtapapu.
And great shopping areas.
We can even take a romantic carriage ride.
Let's do it all.
Yeah, and when we get back, we can tell Mama we spent the whole time in the
library
researching.
You can't imagine how much fun this Dewey Decimal System is.
In that card catalog.
What are we waiting for?
Have fun, you guys. Just remember, be back by 6 o'clock.
Why, Mrs. Marks, you missed all the excitement.
You're wrong.
Card catalog, indeed.
I really don't believe you, Duke.
I am Prince Alexander Daegu.
He's joking, isn't he? Absolutely, Mr. Marks.
See, she was going to say Your Highness, out of habit.
It really doesn't matter to me, Duke. When lightning strikes, you better make the most of it.
Yes, why hello? Yes, yes, things are going swimmingly. I do believe he has, Your Highness. Yes, yes, I'll keep you informed.
Wow, I never realized how these sailing cruises really heat up, especially when you're not single anymore. Is he really a prince?
What else can he do for a living? Waiting for.
Thank you for being so understanding.